George, it's a pleasure to welcome you. Thank you.
Oh, it is. It's a delight to be here. Thank you.
You run a great campus, UC Santa Cruz. UC system itself is very, renowned throughout the country. But being close to the vicinity of Silicon Valley, you have a special emphasis along. So we compete in some sense with UC Berkeley and UC San Francisco. But I think you have other traits that, the other campuses don't. You're mentioning when I was talking to you earlier, you focus on genomics, astrophysics, along with technology and entrepreneurship. Mm-hmm. So I just wanted you to lead and, take genomics as an example, and then we'll delve into the other areas.
Okay. Well, genomics is a real area of strength on the campus. It all started back in the year 2000 when the Human Genome Project was going on. Laboratories all over the world were mapping little pieces of the genome, but no one had figured out how to put the pieces together, like assembling the puzzle. And it was a very difficult problem. But one of our computer scientists, working with a biologist, actually solved that problem. They're the ones who put together the very first draft of the complete human genome, and then we put it up on the web. So we made it available to anyone in the world, and in fact developed the genome browser, which gets today something like 1.3 million hits per day. Wow. It is the preeminent genomics research tool for sharing information. So that was the start. Now UC Santa Cruz is for the United States, it's the National Cancer Genome Hub. It's where the National Cancer Institute has all data come to, and our scientists were a part of beginning the Global Alliance for Genomics and Cancer Research, because they quickly realized they need a larger database than any one country can supply. But if you actually look around the world, the entire world, at the people that are getting treatment for cancer, that's a large enough group, a large enough sample, that you can get some really good results on the effectiveness of treatments and better understand cancer genomics.
This also enables then for you to reach out, or the companies rather, pharmaceutical companies reach out to you for a collaboration.
Absolutely. Pharmaceutical companies, companies that match pharmaceuticals to computer information. In a sense, if you think about, just use cancer as an example, in some sense, cancer has been treated for decades as a biological disease. But in a sense, it's also simply a numerical disease. It represents the fact that several genes in a cell are different than what they should be. So in a sense, it's a digital disease. So there's a computer science or a mathematics aspect to genomics or to disease that's really crucial. And you have to think about it holistically if we're really going to solve the problem of cancer.
In terms of competing for dollars, as they say, each campus has its own challenges.
Yes.
Because you picked up a very critical and important area, does it become any easier or difficult for you?
When you build a reputation, it becomes easier. We have some advantages. My campus is only 50 years old. In fact, we're celebrating our 50th anniversary now, which means in some sense that we're now mature and have to act mature. But in another sense, it's been a huge advantage because we got to build a campus of the 21st century in terms of areas of research and areas of teaching that are interest to the 21st century. Genomics is one example. Computer gaming is another example of something that I couldn't have imagined 25 years ago being a department, but today it's a major part of what we do. So the world is changing, and it allows us to change with the times. And it's helped us tremendously. As a campus, we are actually tied with MIT for number one in the world in terms of research impact, which is measured by the number of citations per paper written by our faculty. And the reason is because we have a number of faculty in different areas who've written very, very important research.
Being close to the Silicon Valley, you are again competing for a piece of the Silicon Valley pie.
Yes.
You can't leave that behind. There are different challenges. How do you then, slice the focus areas in terms of IT and then entrepreneurship?
Really good question and a very difficult question. And in some sense, it's a continuing story that we're still building on. But we have a Silicon Valley Center located in Silicon Valley. We have developed some programs already. We now have a professional master's degree in gaming and playable media located in Silicon Valley. We have a technology management master's program, an applied economics master's program, and we are in the process of developing several more as well. So we have real degree programs located here in Silicon Valley. So we have facilities, we have faculty, we have programs developing. So yes, it's a challenge, but things are happening. The issue for us is to make sure that we develop relationships with the local community, with local companies, with local startups, to make sure that we're interfacing with the places where the action is at. And if we can do that and actually make the right choices, then I think the sky's the limit for us in Silicon Valley.
Charles, it's a pleasure again. Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much. It's really a joy to be here. Thank you.